Hello and welcome to my comparison video comparing the 2021 and the 2022 summer waves. So in this video I'll be comparing similar sets from both waves, kind of going on price and like how similar sets are like scene sets or ships. If you do enjoy this video, please subscribe because I'll be doing this more in the future. So I'm going to start off with the 75310 Jewel Mandalore with 147 pieces and the ATST with 87 pieces being set 75332. These are like two of the smallest sets from both of the waves. All of the sets from 2021 will be on the left, 2022 on the right. The 75310 cost £18 or $20, and the 75332 cost £30 or $35, which is ridiculously expensive considering it only has 87 pieces. Mainly some of the pieces are big, but still really, really overpriced. But the minifigures are quite good for both of the sets. I do prefer the Jewel Mandalore's one with the Ahsoka and Maul minifigures because both of them are really, really good minifigures, especially with the Maul being exclusive. And then the other set has good minifigures, but none of them really stand out in the same way. Sets themselves, neither of them are really that interesting. The vault for this one has a nice sticker. If it was printed, it would be considerably cooler. But it's probably really annoying to stick on. And then like the throne itself is kind of cool as well. And then the other set has, yeah, I just really don't like the 4 plus style sets. They're not great. And I think obviously the 75310 Jewel Mandalore wins, meaning 2021 has 1 point. Next we have the 75311 Imperial Armoured Marauder, 478 pieces costing £35 or $40. And the Obi-Wan Kenobi Jedi Starfighter being 75333, 282 pieces costing $30 and £30. So both have interesting minifigures. I think they are kind of similar in terms of like how good they are. The Greek Karga minifigure and the Mortar Trooper are both really, really good. Whereas the Kaminoan minifigure and Obi-Wan are pretty cool, albeit the Kaminoan figure probably could have been done better in my opinion. But the set itself has a lot of play features with quite a few stud shooters, a lot of interior for a bunch of the minifigures, and yeah, a lot of turrets, a swivel, space in the back for storage, a bunch of hatches, ways to open it up, a lot of play features. It just doesn't look very clean. It is not very well, like there's a lot of studs and it doesn't look to be very accurate because it's very noisy, I suppose, when you would say it when you look at it. Whereas the Obi-Wan Starfighter is extremely clean, well done, and just looks so cool. There's like the studs are really well done with the plates. It kind of balances out to make it really cool. Really, the new stud shooters look kind of terrible on the front, but they're really easy to remove. But yeah, this is a really impressive set. Quite a few less play features than the other set, but still has a decent number. But then, I do think it is still the better set. It just looks really, really nice. Albeit the gap you can see between like the midsection and like the red wing part is kind of off-putting. It is still quite impressive. And that makes it one all. Then we have kind of the scene sets with slightly different prices compared to the rest of them. With 75319, the Armourer's Mandalorian Forge with 258 pieces costing £25 or $30. And the 75334 Obi-Wan Kenobi versus Darth Vader, 408 pieces, costing £45 or $50. Both have really impressive minifigures in my opinion. Obviously the Mandalorian's in a lot of sets, but the armor and the Paz Vizsla minifigures are both really cool. The other set has really good Ned B and, well, I don't really like the Tala, but Darth Vader farm printing is quite nice, and the Obi-Wan minifigure is also pretty cool. Comes to this set, there are a few play features with, like, you know, the Beskar, which you can put on the Blue Fire, which is really, really cool. I think this one's a much better display set, but then there's the Beskar, and I don't know why I like it so much, but the blank Mandalorian helmet in the background looks pretty cool, and it is quite a nice set, plenty of detail, whereas this is really lacking in detail, in my opinion, but has a lot of play features. You know, you can knock up onto the yellow rocks off, you can spin them around as if they're dueling, it separates and you can put flames in the middle. It is just not very appealing, like it's really wouldn't probably be too hard to build something better than this, my opinion, yourself, and especially considering how much it costs, would have maybe been nicer had they gone with a more traditional price for the dual set and gone for like a £20 set and made it much smaller. But yeah, I don't really like the way this set looks, in my opinion. So, in my opinion, the Armorer's Mandalorian Forge is the better set, and I just think it has more detail compared to the other one, which gives it a edge. And then we have the 75316 Mandalorian Starfighter with 544 pieces, costing £60 or dollars, and the Mandalorian's N1 Starfighter with 412 pieces, and it costs £50 or $60. Sets of similar names, considering how different they are. But we have Gar Saxon, Bo-Katan, and a Mandalorian Loyalist, all brilliantly detailed, all look really, really cool, especially the Gar Saxon with his helmet. Other set has alright minifigures, just none of them really stand out, especially considering how many sets Mandalorian's in, and the sets themselves. This one is ridiculously cool. The wings fold up for landing position, the cockpit area swings around 360, as is the turret on the back. Has two stud shooters, two spring-loaded shooters, space for two of the minifigures inside, and is just a really, really impressive set. A lot of detail, is really, really good to look at, and is quite an impressive set, and one of the favourite sets that LEGO has done recently. Compared to the N1 Starfighter, it's kind of impressive. It just doesn't look very sleek or as clean. It just doesn't look as well finished as, like, what it should be in the show, and it kind of gets the idea across of it being like assembled from scrap, but it doesn't actually look much like the show. For example, the wing parts are far too studded in my opinion, and they're not really well designed, like they're far too flat as well. It does have plenty of play features though, with the space to put the Mandalorian and Baby Yoda, and then a place for his jetpack and a spring-loaded shooter underneath, which can be used by pressing the engine, which is quite nicely incorporated in my opinion. And I do think the Mandalorian Starfighter is the better set. It is just, I really like the way it looks. The colours look really nice. It has really good minifigures. And yeah, it just is, in my opinion, a better set. Then we have the kind of display sets with the 75296 Darth Vader's Meditation Chamber with 663 pieces. Costing quite a lot considering it is, for the size, it's £60 or $70. It just doesn't look like that to me. And then we have the BD1 75335 with 1,062 pieces, costing $90 or $100. Minifigures don't matter, one has General Veers and Darth Vader, the other one has BD1. It is a really nice set. Darth Vader's Meditation Chamber has the nice like plaque attached to it, the stand is really nice. It just doesn't look that big for the price. You can fit Darth Vader on the inside. He has like a nice chair with kind of the panels around him. And then the screen in front of him. And then, but the BD-1 is like a foot tall. Quite impressed. The plaque looks pretty nice. You know, you have your more details on it. Quite a lot of posability. And therefore you can display it at a lot more angles than the other one. And in my opinion, is just much better value, meaning it wins. It also has a couple features which I kind of like, with like a drawer in its head, which is quite impressive in my opinion, and a really well designed set. We have the 75314, the Bad Batch Attack Shuttle, 969 pieces, and the 75336 Inquisitor Transport Scythe with 924 pieces, both costing £90 or $100, so it's kind of a fair fight. For the Bad Batch set, they didn't do any custom helmets other than Tex, which results in the minifigures looking much worse compared to the Inquisitor Scythe, with the custom chest pieces for the Grand Inquisitor and the Fifth Buzzer, albeit they both had ones before that weren't made for the Kenobi characters, but probably would have done the job. So kind of makes it slightly better towards the Kenobi set, albeit the Bad Batch minifigures, there is another couple of them. The sets themselves, this one comes with two speeder bikes, one of which is, the green one's really impressive and nicely detailed, the other one's the same as the 501st Battle Pack, minus a couple blasters. But the set itself, I originally didn't like the sand blue, but it has grown on me and I think it looks really nice. It has a nice interior, I can fit all four of the Bad Batch members, and yeah, it is just quite an impressive set. The Inquisitor Scythe also has interior to fit all the minifigures, and the wings fold down, as does the other one. They both have spring-loaded shooters, as making them quite similar set. It's just the aesthetic of this one is really impressive. I do like the full black look, but I do think the other one is slightly more... I just kind of prefer Clone Wars set, so I have to consider it a draw. So that means both sides will get half a point. And we have the 75312 Boba Fett Starship Slave 1. 593 pieces costing £44, or £45 even, and $50. And the 75338 Ambushon Ferrix with 680 pieces costing £70 or $70. Both being interesting sets in my opinion, kind of. They both are quite unique as well, considering the Slave 1 is so scaled down. But the minifigures are nice. You have Boba Fett and the Mandalorian, both of which nicely detailed, albeit both in other sets. Then we have the other minifigures, which they don't really stand out. Like Cassian Andor looks fine. It's just none of the other two, because the show hasn't come out yet, they don't stand out as much. And the sets themselves, the scaled down Slave 1, in my opinion, looks really, really quite impressive, considering how fairly scaled down it is. It has a nice, like, stand slash, like, transport thing, which I think is a really nice inclusion. It is really useful for displaying the set. The wings tilt with it, which is quite nice. A space for a minifigure inside is just quite an impressive set. Then we have the Ambushon Ferrix. I'm not the biggest fan of the set. It just doesn't look like a £70 set to me. I'm not really sure why. The speeder bike is pretty cool. I do like the speeder bike. It is nicely detailed. But the set itself just looks like a grey box, which just doesn't... It doesn't stand out aesthetically. It has a nice interior, but it just really looks very cramped anyway. And not really the most impressive for a set. So I do think the Slave 1 is better, especially considering the number of pieces it's got for the price. And yeah, I do think that 2021 at the moment is much better of a wave. And then we have the Clone Wars. So this is because there are more sets in 2022. I've just done the kind of all the Clone Wars-ish ones, even though the Ultimate Collector Series one isn't really a Clone Wars set. But anyway, so 75309, 3,292 pieces, UCS Republic gunship. It is very expensive, costing £310 or $400. But then we have the 75337 ATT Walker, 1,082 pieces, and it cost £120 or $140. Public fighter tank, 75342, and 262 pieces, costing £35 or $40. Totaling that side for 2022, £155 or $180. Then the minifigures. We have a Mace Windu and a Clone Commander versus Mace Windu, 8 clones and 5 battle droids. Not really a competition, especially considering they could have put a Commander Cody, which was really wanted for the set, and a Mace Windu with arm printing in the set, considering they both came out a year later. So not much competition for the minifigures. Then the sets themselves. This looks cool. I don't really like the cannons on top. That is my main flaw of the set. But I do think the rest of the set looks really nice. It is impressive. It's very big. It has a nice stand. And yeah, it's just what you'd expect for a UCS set. Whereas, the Republic fighter tank doesn't look that good. Easily modified if you could be bothered. Minifigures are very nice, so it's kind of gives it the edge, but it just looks really flat, especially considering the sides are just like all level. Then the ATT, quite impressive. Obviously the spider droid instead of a crab droid kind of sucks, but the set itself is really nice, especially considering it is a lot of interior with like more seats than minifigures for the set, and is just a really impressive set. Not much competition here, obviously. The points go to 2022, just not really any competition. The UCS gunship's nice, but compared to two of these sets, yeah. The 75315 Imperial Light Cruiser with 13,036 pieces cost £140 or $160. And the 75323, the Justifier, 1,022 pieces, costing £150 or $170. Both really big sets, some of the biggest in their wave. Minifigures, both have very impressive minifigures, both have Fennec Shand. I do kind of prefer the Justifier set. I just think the Cad Bane minifigure is really nice, and I'm not that big a fan of the Moff Gideon minifigure. The sets themselves, this is very impressive. It looks really cool. It has a bunch of features, like you can shoot out mini TIE fighters. It has a decent interior and a couple of cannons on top with a whole bunch of spring-loaded shooters, and is quite an impressive set. Whereas the Justifier has some interior. I don't really, like, we don't like to show any pictures of it, but yes, it does have some. It is alright looking, it's just not my favourite looking set. It doesn't really, the sides just really lack detail, like the front part, that sides, they just really lack that much detail that it just kind of ruins the aesthetic of the set, and is not one of the sets that you might have expected to be this price and this big. You might have expected it to be more like the Knights of Ren ship from a couple of years ago. But I do think that the 75315 Imperial Light Cruiser is the better set, meaning the final scores are 2022 with 3.5 points and 2021 with 5.5 points. If you disagree, let me know in the comment sections below. But thanks for watching. Do hope you did enjoy this video. See you in the next one.